Lukas. I'm the education director at the Spellman Museum of Stamps and Postal History, which is located on the campus of Regis College in Weston, Massachusetts. And this is our monthly show in which we feature postage stamps that relate to historic events, to famous people, and to maybe some interesting news about what's been happening with stamps over the past month or so. So we hope that you enjoy the show. We always welcome comments from you. And you can always reach us, even though we'd love you to send us a letter. You can also email us, and you can see our email address at the bottom of the screen. So to get started, let me just tell you that every month we do produce a calendar, which we're happy to email to you, and it features a number of the stamps that we mentioned here on the show, as well as some other events happening during the month of March that are historic and connect to stamps. So just email us, and we'd be happy to send it to you. Since this is March, we found a lot of stamps that have clocks on them. And that got me to thinking that, well, March is when we do daylight saving time. Starts on March 10th and it goes until November 3rd. There's a little philatelic connection in that the man who first thought of daylight savings time was named Benjamin Franklin. He suggested the idea back in 1784. Some people thought it was a joke. But in 1907, the idea was revised by a man in Germany. And then after World War I began as a fuel-saving method, Germans went to daylight savings time in 1915. British did it a year later, and then the United States went to it when we entered the war in 1918 with the Standard Time Act. They did away with it in 1920, but during World War II, they went again back to a daylight saving time period. And then in 1966, the Uniform Time Act was passed, and everybody was on the same changing of clocks. Interestingly, there are two states, Arizona and Hawaii, that do not do daylight savings time. And I just also realized that it's not daylight savings time anymore. For some reason, we call it daylight saving time. And there's one very nice stamp behind me here from the country of Bangladesh, which features a little visual about daylight saving time. So if it's before March 10th, remember to spring ahead 2 o'clock in the morning. So a little bit of interesting stamp news from Britain. Turns out that in the category of everybody can make a mistake, a few months ago, the British Post Office decided to issue a stamp celebrating the anniversary of D-Day. And they published an image of the stamp and some possibly veterans, or at least people who know their military history, noticed that the British government had made a little mistake. And it was supposed to be the beach at Normandy, but it turned out to be a beach in Dutch New Guinea. And they also had the wrong landing craft included. So fortunately, enough people noticed it, and the British Post Office was embarrassed, but that stamp did not get printed, and the changes were made. So this is also March is Women's History Month, and there's a couple of interesting connections to philately. First off, you'll see behind me, the Post Office has issued a number of stamps honoring famous women and the suffrage movement. It turns out, though, that women are still very underrepresented on stamps, probably a 4-to-1 ratio between men and women on stamps. But there is one connection, that the very first postage stamp designed by a woman did not take place until 1938. The first postage stamp in America was 1847, but it wasn't until the late 30s. Elaine Rawlinson submitted a design for a series of presidents on stamps. And there were thousands of entries, but she was selected, and her stamp design was selected for a series known as the Prexy series. So that was in 1938, and it wasn't again till 1963 when another woman was chosen to design a stamp. That was Lily Spandorf, and she designed the 63 Christmas issue. There have been a number of other women since designing stamps, but it still seems to be a man's world as far as stamp designing goes. So March is, as we said, Women's History Month. It's also National Peanut Month. And if you are hoping, we hope you think about giving blood this month because it's National Red Cross Month. And for all our Irish folks out there, we wish you a happy St. Patrick's Day because it's also Irish American Month. And we have number of stamps there from Ireland. Another thing that was in the news related, it's kind of a stamp kind of predicting possibly what might happen in the future, and it's a stamp that comes out of China. And it, since this is the year of the boar, they put it out, a stamp with the pigs on it. Turns out there are three little piggies on this China stamp. Seems like an innocent enough stamp, except some people are reading some politics into it. As you know, China for a while had a one-child policy. Families could have only one child. That changed a couple of years ago in 2017, and now there's a thought that maybe they'll put the limit to three, and so they think maybe this stamp with the three little piggies would be an indication of that. Turns out in 2017 they put out a stamp with two monkeys on it, again possibly related to children. We do a little traveling, try to get people around, and somebody up in Portland sent us a picture of a Japanese mailbox, and they weren't quite sure why was there a Japanese mailbox in Portland. Well, for two reasons. So actually, one, turns out Portland has a sister city in Japan, but that led me to do a little investigating about the postal system in Japan. And there's a very famous man, Majima Hisoka, who is considered the father of the Japanese postal service in the 1870s. He actually was sent to Great Britain to study their postal system, and he came back and instituted a delivery system for the Japanese government. And I believe that's why the Japanese post mailboxes looked very similar to the to the British post offices. And you can see that picture up in Portland. So another kind of interesting travel thing. We have a viewer who recently came back from Iceland, and we did a little research on that. And we found out that in Iceland, a few years ago, there was a volcano explosion. You may remember it. It actually kept a lot of the planes from flying around. And so to celebrate this volcanic eruption, the Icelandic post office decided to issue stamps with a little bit of volcanic ash included in each stamp. And they made a limited amount, but they became big collector's items. And this is not unusual for other countries to do similar things with adding something on the stamp. So interesting, just a way of doing something a little different with stamps. And now it's time for our favorite stamp collecting alligator, Archie the Alligator. Archie, come on up. Arch, what do you got here? Oh, it's a shark. How about that? Why do you have a shark, Archie? I know why. Archie read a story about another famous alligator called Charlie, who got himself on videos all around the country because he attacked a shark. Yeah, and outside a seafood restaurant down in Hilton Head, South Carolina. It's a little unusual for alligators to attack sharks, but he did, and he won the battle. So they filmed it from the restaurant, and as I said, it went viral. And Archie saw the story, and he said, well, maybe I'm going to try. But Archie then also is now collecting sharks on stamps, and you can see a bunch of those from around the world there. So, okay, Arch, keep your eye out for any wayward sharks, and see if you can take care of them. Whoa, okay. All right. If you also remember our last episode, last month, we went on the road, and Archie here had given me a pith helmet that mailmen wear in the summertime, and we took a trip over to Boston, to the Boston Post Road areas, such as Faneuil Hall and the Old South Meeting House. Now we're going to show you another segment that we filmed. Oh, wait a minute, I'm getting some message here from the crew. Oh, Archie, the film's not ready. You blew it. So take your helmet back, and we'll see you next month. Thanks. Thanks, Arch. You notice we did a few months ago show you a big ball of stamps from Boys Town. One of our viewers sent in this photograph. They visited Boys Town, and they had a picture taken in front of the ball there. And then it also turns out that one of our other viewers, from Sophie from Canada, told us that in Spain they had sculpture, a giant statue of a woman in stamps honoring the artist Diego Velázquez. His painting Las Meninas, Ladies in Waiting, this is the lady in waiting, and this big statue appeared in Madrid, Spain, at the Plaza Mayor some time ago. So people seem to be decorating all sorts of things with stamps. By the way, those viewers from who sent us the Boys Town stamp, that's Denise Hare, and she lives out in Temecula, California. So we always do our presidents on stamps, and so we have a few presidents who were born this month, and we have a few presidents who died this month. We have four presidents born in the month of March: President Cleveland, President Tyler, President Jackson, and President Madison. And four presidents died in the month of March: Millard Fillmore, Benjamin Harrison, William Howard Taft, and Dwight D. Eisenhower. I think I've mentioned to you that when you get a group of 35 or more people, there are very good chances their birthdays are the same month and day. Well, it may be that you get that many people together. We've had 45 presidents, and two of them died on the same day, different years, on March 8th. That was Fillmore and Taft. So a little mathematical introduction there. So trivia time. We have a trivia question. Actually, we have two questions this month. Let's answer give the answer to last month's trivia question. We had two stamps. We had the President Kennedy stamp issued shortly after his death and the Air Force One stamp. And we wanted to know what the philatelic connection was. And it turns out that the man who designed the Kennedy stamp also designed the coloring and design on Air Force One. He was asked by the First Lady Jackie Kennedy. She liked his work and that she wasn't satisfied with some of the stamp designs, so she contacted Mr. Lowry, was his name, very famous designer, and in top secret, he did design that Kennedy stamp, and he also, again, designed Air Force One. So that was the philatelic connection. Now for our two questions this month. One of them, I'm showing you a picture of four men, and I'd like to know, what is the stamp connection to these four men? They have, and if you know that answer, you can email it to us at info@spellman.org. The other trivia question, you'll see two stamps up there. One is a statue of Abraham Lincoln, and another is a statue of the Rough Rider from the Spanish-American War. And my question to you is, what connection can you make between those two stamps? And actually, you could probably find a third stamp that also has a connection to that. So if you know the answer to either one or both, please email us, and we'd be happy to send you a couple of free postage stamps. By the way, the names of the people who provided their answers for that trivia question on Air Force One and the Kennedy stamp, you'll see their names down below. So let's move on to another interesting thing I saw in the news. There's a new museum. Every month we try to mention some museums. Turns out it's not quite a museum, but it's a hall of fame for mascots, for college mascots, baseball team, football team mascots. And they have about 1,800 different mascots represented in this hall of fame. Made me go look for some mascots on stamps. And sure enough, you'll see a few stamps behind me that feature different mascots, some of them from the Olympics, some of them from other places. So you might want to check it out. It's in Indiana. And if you had a college mascot, or a high school mascot, and you want to let them know about it to see if it's in their record. So check that out on that. And also, we always have our student viewers from India, and we'd like to feature an Indian stamp each month. I found a stamp with six scientists, Indian scientists are on there, and I want our Indian stamp collectors to do a little research and to find out why those six scientists are on that Indian stamp. So those are going through my notes here. We always cover a lot of material. I got a lot more to share with you, but I guess we'll have to do that next month. So thank you for watching the show. Please send us any comments you have. Don't forget the trivia. And if you mention that you've seen the show when you come to the museum, we'll give you a nice big discount on admission. So again, pleasure talking with you. I hope you learned a little bit about stamps, and we'll see you in April.